WordPress is absolutely the best way to host your website, and it's free. And I've been using WordPress for 10 years, and I'm gonna walk you through on my computer right here exactly how to use all of the different elements of WordPress so that you can have the best website possible. Let's get it. So here I am logged into Bluehost, and this is what I use to register my sites. And I'm gonna go to My Sites right here, and we're gonna log into my site, selfemploymentresources.online. So I'm just gonna click log into WordPress to get into WordPress initially. Now, what I like about Bluehost, it makes it really simple to see your sites and log into stuff without having anything fancy. Okay, so here we are in the main WordPress dashboard. This is what it should look like, or roughly look like, depending on where you registered your site. So what I'll be going over in this video is I'll be going over a few different things. I'll be talking about the themes for your site, which dictates the look and feel of things. I'm gonna talk about plugins, which can help you with tracking or marketing your site. I'm gonna talk about pages and posts, which are the main elements of your site, and when to determine how to use pages or posts. So here I am logged into WordPress, and the first thing you will see is it says get started, and you can customize your site. Now, if I wanted to, I could go right here and I could click change my theme completely. I could also go over to this area, which is appearance, and I could click themes right here, and I could select a different theme if I wanted to. The theme dictates what your site looks like. So as you see, I'm running off of this one. See, active 2017, but we could also make my site look like 2015. See, it's a little bit different. It has a two column layout as 1/3 and 2/3. We can also do 2019, which is another different layout. It's kind of just, again, one column. Or we could do 2016, which is a 2/3 and then 1/3 layout, also a blog. Or you could find new themes. You could buy themes by clicking this button, premium themes, and you can purchase different websites that look fancier or less fancy. I'm not gonna click in there. You can click in there, you can browse for hours. There's thousands of themes out there, maybe even tens of thousands, and they generally cost anywhere between like 20 to 50 bucks. But you get yourself a really customized, very unique look to your website. That being said, I don't think it's too necessary when you get started, because honestly, people care more about the content. It doesn't matter if you have the most beautiful site in the world. If nobody's going to it, it doesn't really matter. Let's go into plugins. So plugins allow you to extend the functionality of WordPress. They're little kind of software things that you put in WordPress, and they can make it look different, or they can make it function differently, etc. Now, WordPress generally comes pre-installed with a few different plugins. You see it has this plugin called Akismet Anti-Spam. It says used by millions. It is a way to protect your blog from spam. There's a lot of people on the internet that will just post, you know, random spam trying to get you to sign up for porno sites or Viagra pills or, you know, ways to, you know, scammy ways to make money online, and you want to protect your site from that. That's a really, it's just really smart. And generally speaking, it comes pre-installed. What you would do to activate it is you'd simply click this button that says activate. And I'll click that right now. And as you see, you have to set up your Akismet account. I'm not going to go through the setup steps, but it's free to set up, and you can just click there to set it up. Now, you already have, I installed ClickFunnels on this site just for another demonstration I did. ClickFunnels is a software I use to, because I actually use ClickFunnels to build my sites. I use WordPress as the kind of framework, and then I build them more customizable in ClickFunnels. Now, you see, you have this other one called Hello Dolly. And this allows you to see random song lyric on your website if you want it to. So we could just activate this. Kind of funny, right? And then you have this. So you have Jetpack by WordPress. And this allows you to connect your blog to your WordPress account and other stuff. why you would add other plugins, because they can help you make more money and get your site out there. For instance, let's look up plugins SEO. If I search the keyword SEO, you'll see one of the most popular plugins is called Yoast SEO. And Yoast SEO will help you optimize your site to show more in the search rankings. Really good thing, and I would just, the way you would use it, you can click on this to learn more information. So I'm installing Yoast, and that's how you would install it, and then you'd click activate. And this would help your site show up better in search rankings. You can do other things to help your site show up better in search rankings, such as use Lightspeed Cache, which will help your site load faster, and you would install that here. And there's all sorts of things. I'm not gonna delve into what SEO is, but it helps you show up in Google, which gets you traffic. I'm gonna talk about next are pages that are standard, they're locked in on your website. Generally speaking, you're gonna use, your pages are gonna be, they're not blog posts, okay? They'll be like about us, contact us, privacy policy, terms of use. These are what I consider pages on your site, and you will use them, or if you have a local business, you'll use them for location. So here's a good example, privacy policy. Now, posts are the blog posts you come out with. If you are gonna put out regular content, let's say for me, for instance, I put out regular content about how to make money online, how to quit your job, how to find remote jobs, I would put up blog posts. I would just click add new and I'd write that blog post about whatever I'm gonna do. Now the best way if you wanna show up in search rankings is to post daily, okay? Daily for months on end. I know that sounds like a big commitment, and it is. You need to be posting for at least 3 to 4 months before you really expect to see any results. But I might say, how to earn money online as a teenager. That's something that people search for. So then I would just start writing here. This would be the title, and I'd say, if you're a teenager, you can make money online 4 different ways, you know, then, you know, I just write right away until I'm satisfied. Generally speaking, you want your post to be between 250 and 1,000 words to show up best on SEO. There's more functionality to WordPress if you really dive in deep. My suggestion to you is if you really are interested in building a blog and extending your site even further, you can just delve in and don't be afraid. It's not gonna hurt you, and just click around. Click into the comments, click into the appearance, click into the plugins and the users and the tools and the settings. All of these things are not gonna hurt you, but that's the best way to learn about WordPress and get deeper. That's all the time we have for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're looking to learn more about how to do marketing online, or what I do to make money online, I do what's called affiliate marketing, and I have a free course on my YouTube. So I make millions of dollars a year selling other people's products. I don't have any employees, don't have any technical skills, but I know simple things like how to post videos and how to do WordPress, and I can show you how to make money online doing that sort of stuff in this course. All you have to do is subscribe to my channel, and you will get this course. Also, if you want to see any future topics or future topic requests, make sure to leave a comment or a question, and I'll answer it. And like this video and hit that notification bell to let me know you love me. So talk to you soon. Have a good day.